Thanks for that, Robert. I'm so glad everyone is safe. On to space news now, and NASA have confirmed that they are going ahead with their mission to bring samples of rocks and soil from Mars to Earth. It's hoped the Mars Sample Return Program could reveal more about the early solar system and whether life may have existed on the red planet. But what about this year? 2025 is also set to be a big one for space exploration. And here's Ricky with everything you need to know.
3, 2, 1, ignition, and liftoff of Starliner and Atlas V, carrying two American heroes.
Remember Sunny and Butch, the two NASA astronauts who blasted off into space last summer but have been stuck there ever since? Well, 2025 will see them both finally come back to Earth, hopefully. Sunny Williams and Butch Wilmore travelled to the International Space Station in June 2024 for what was supposed to be an 8-day mission. However, problems with the spacecraft they travelled on, the Boeing Starliner, meant the pair had to have their stay extended, and NASA say they're now expected to return in early spring on a different space capsule. Other space agencies are also planning missions for later this year. Among others, China is scheduled to launch its Tianwen-2 mission for asteroid exploration, and the European Space Agency is planning the first flight of Space Rider, its reusable space plane. Now, when you think of Saturn, you probably picture the planet with its iconic rings around it. However, the grand site is set to disappear from Earth's view in March. It's all down to an optical illusion due to Saturn's tilt, which will turn the vast hoops into an almost invisible line. But don't worry, it won't be forever, as you'll be able to see them again when the planet tilts back towards Earth at the end of the year. 2025 is also set to mark the end of some big missions in space. NASA's Juno spacecraft took 5 years to reach Jupiter, the solar system's largest planet. For the past 8 years, it's provided dazzling views of the giant gas planet and its satellites, and even had its mission extended. However, the US Space Agency has said that it now expects Juno's time in space to end no later than September. And back on Earth, there will be two partial solar eclipses and two lunar eclipses to look forward to this year. An eclipse of the Moon takes place when the Earth is positioned directly between the Moon and the Sun, and our planet's shadow hides the lunar surface. And it will also be visible across the UK in September.